Grossman's apartment. First of all, this used to be Peter Lawford's apartment. But now it is clearly Pepper's apartment, especially this room. Yeah. Look at all your costumes and all this fan art.
Right?
It is incredible.
It's pretty great.
This is amazing. And this is just stuff people have given you?
Yeah.
Holy cow.
Yeah, if I ever need an ego boost, I just come in here.
Yeah, for sure.
You know? I mean, it's like it's moving. Like, my art inspired others' art.
I love it. This is a great room. Mm-hmm. And this is where we are going to start our ghost investigation.
Woo!
Skirt. All right. Let me show you what I brought.
Okay.
Okay, so this is just your standard EMF meter. So here's what happens. You turn it on, and you saw how it goes all the way up to red?
Yeah.
Well, typically it's gonna stay at green, unless it starts sensing a presence. So it can go darker green, yellow, orange, or all the way to red. And then sometimes when something's very, very strong in front of it, it'll go all the way to red, and then shut off, all the way to red, shut off, like it starts like just freaking out, and you can tell. It doesn't make any noise, that's just how it is. So you just have to kind of watch for the lights and stuff, but it's kind of a good thing too, to like leave it, say we leave it in this room and then we walk out, but you have a camera on it. So you can kind of see if anything's happening while you're out of a room. Okay. This right here is a laser thermometer. You are 80.
What?
85.5. You are hot.
Well, I mean, obviously.
Clearly, right? So sometimes when energy comes around, there is cold spots.
Oh.
And so in order to help determine whether, you know, instead of just being like, yeah, that feels colder than right here or whatever, you have like an actual laser thermometer where you can point at the actual, so you see the little laser dot.
Okay.
And point at the actual spot where you think it's cooler and get a temperature reading.
Okay.
This, my dad actually just got me.
Okay.
That's so sweet, right? This is, as you can see, it looks a lot like this one, but because it has a K2 meter built into it. It also has a laser thermometer built into it. And so you can walk around with it and do both at the same time without having like all kinds of equipment in your hand. So I brought this so we could just have them in a couple different places. And then this, Peter Lawford, he was friends with the Kennedys, right?
Right.
So this is one of his campaign pins. Ooh. So maybe that will inspire Peter to want to come and take a look at it. Peter, if you're around and you want to come and take a look at this, a little blast from the past, it actually just lit up to yellow when I said that. Peter, are you here with us?
I'm freaking out.
I don't really like this. It's like, okay, we can stop now. Peter, why don't you come say hi to the pin? Come check it out.
You know, this is like really Pepper's room, though. I wonder if Peter's feeling like it's no longer his.
It's possible.
I mean, maybe we should go.
It's possible, but I did see it light up to yellow.
Oh, I don't want to see it. Maybe
I feel like something. Peter, are you here? Do you want to come say hi? You're like, please don't.
I oh.
Oh, God.
Wait, so why would that happen, though? I don't understand.
So something is creating electromagnetic field that this is sensing. So things can cause that. Like if it's too close to an electrical outlet or an appliance or whatever, those have electromagnetic fields. But when you have it in the middle of a room like this, typically there's nothing else. That just sparked again. Typically there's nothing else that could be generating it to turn. Peter, is that you? Do you want to come say hi? Will you come closer to this little gadget here so we can see you?
He did have an affinity for hot girls.
Really?
Like yourself, yes.
Oh, yeah?
Well, and me, for that matter.
Yeah.
Yeah. 85.
Well, then he should be coming checking us out.
Seriously.
Can you light up this little meter to red? Ooh, got a little something. We need you to light it all the way up to red. You have to get closer for that.
Oh,
he did it! Oh my God! Wow. Was that you? Is that you?
Like,
can you do it one more time?
I don't know about you.
You really
I can
do.
Feel him. He's here.
Can you light it to red one more time? So we know it's you? I just want to make sure it wasn't a fluke. Just have to come a little bit closer to light them up to red. Are you checking out the pin? Or just the hot girls? Oh my god! You're right about my bloody hot girls!
Seriously. Wow. You know what we should do? We should put some alcohol out.
Yeah.
I guess it's kind of an alcohol.
Oh, really? Well, do you want a drink? Do you want to have a drink with us? I don't know how that works in the afterlife. It might go right through them.
That's true. That's true.
Well, I think this is also, this is already an awesome reading.
Definitely.
I mean, I feel like we made contact.
For sure.
The temperature stayed pretty consistent, though. It's a 72. That's pretty normal. I don't feel any weird cold spots or anything.
Although, I got really cold at
that point. The chills. Yeah. The chills is kind of different than the cold spots, though. Oh. Like, the cold spots are really crazy. If you ever feel one, there's, like, it's literally just, like, a bundle of air. And it just feels so much different than, like, the temperature over here.
Wow. It's weird. You know, this condo is really cold. Like, in general.
Yeah.
It's... Like, I have to heat it. I have to, you know, it's like a cold place. I don't think it's just me.
Well.
I don't know if that,
I don't know. Because usually it's certain spots.
Right.
Okay. You know?
Got it.
But I think that just is a insulation issue or something.
Probably. Yeah. You know, exactly. Northern facing, first floor. Yeah.
Ooh, we're getting something. That's what I like about this one, too, is that it makes noise.
So, how do they differ again?
Well, this one just has combination of some of those things in it. This part is the same in it. Mm-hmm. Should we walk around a little bit?
Yeah. I feel him in my bedroom.
Yeah? Should we go sit on your bed and see?
I do.
If he wants to join us?
Yes. You know he does.
Okay. Let's go see.
I also, like I said, where it actually happened, the flicker, that is, was in the front room. So, I wouldn't be surprised.
Ooh, was something going? I heard clicking. Now?
Oh. I don't know. Should we?
All right, Peter. Where are you at? Do you like this room better? I mean, he seemed to really like the other room.
He really did. There's a lot to like in there.
I like the other room. What do you think? Can you follow us in here? Can you come in this room with us? You have to get close and light up the meter so we know you're here.
This is his bedroom, so, you know, maybe he's asleep.
That's true. Well, we'll give him a few minutes to find us. He's like, where'd they go?
Yeah, right.
We're just here. Hmm. Peter, you want to come and join us in this room? I think he's upset. He's like, wait, where's that drink they promised?
Yeah, right? I wonder if that big metal desk had anything to do with anything.
It's possible. Hmm. I don't know. You don't like this room as much?
Hmm.
We know you come in here sometimes. Naomi can sense it.
Mm-hmm.
Not today.
Interesting.
Nothing. Are you shy? Want us to go to a different room?
Wow. What?
He doesn't like it in here.
He doesn't.
So you don't like it in here? Or did you just find us? Maybe I should ask one question at a time. Light it up if you want us to go to a different room. Can you light it up? Okay, can you light it up if you just found us in here? You have to come close in order to light it up. I mean, I feel like he wanted us to go to a different room.
The way he said,
yeah. Yeah, because it totally went red twice.
Yeah.
All right. All right, we're going to go to a different room. Follow us. Okay, Peter, this is where you flickered the lights.
Mm-hmm.
Can you do it again? You can make the lights flicker, or you can come close and light up our meters. Either way, we just want to confirm that you're here.
When the lights flickered, it really did feel like he was sending me some approval. You know what I mean?
He's like, you go, girl. This is what this place is all about.
Exactly.
Were you sending Naomi a message? Were you proud of her for going out?
I have a picture of him.
Ooh, yeah. We're going to pull out a picture of you. Aww.
Right?
Wow, handsome.
Right? Very.
Very handsome.
On a yacht, no less.
Yeah. Very cool. All right, so now we kind of have you here with us. Do you want to come and say hi? Come and light up the meters. You have to get close to do it.
Don't get me wrong, I'm a little bit relieved it's not, like, blasting red. You know what I mean? Like, I have to live here.
We've got quite a bit of red, though.
Yeah?
Are you here with us? I think he really likes pepper room.
I think so, too.
Oh, that's cute, though. I think we found your favorite room.
Yeah.
I think you like the other room the best. Come say hi one more time and we'll let you go. I mean, we have your picture out here, the Kennedy pin. Like, we came prepared.
I think he wants us to actually throw a rager.
Maybe. Nothing more? You done? Did we poop you out?
You know, we'll do this again. At one point, the neighbors and I all threw a little soiree where we had Ocean's 8 or one of those, you know, one of his films. We played on the wall
and we
all just, like, in the middle of the summer, like, jumped in the pool and, you know, threw a big party.
Yeah.
And he was definitely with us that night. And you'll have to come with your gadgets.
I'll come with my gadgets.
Yeah.
Are you here with us? I have one more fun thing. I don't know how accurate it is, but it's just a fun thing. I'm gonna grab my phone.
Yeah. Scary.
Okay, so Nick, that's my fiance.
Yeah.
He was lighting up right now.
It was.
He tells me that. He tells me that this app does not. That the iPhone has nothing to detect ghosts, but I have this ghost detector app on here.
I think he does not like that you have a fiance.
I know, it's like, you know, since I said his name. And this sometimes...
It was just like going crazy for a second.
It says tense. This picks up EVPs and it has a little EMF meter in it and stuff. And I don't know how accurate these are because Nick says, your iPhone doesn't have ghost detecting capabilities, but you would be shocked at how amazingly accurate this is along with the other equipment. So sometimes I like to just get it out for fun and even if it's not accurate.
What are the, I mean, tense versus
chill.
So it just picks up weird. I mean, a lot of times it's going to be just like weird words. Like it'll say bill, or it'll go water, drought. Like it'll just say weird, weird stuff. And it's just like picking up on different things, supposedly, mm-hmm. and grabbing what it senses. So it's called spectral communication, or EVPs. Ghost detected. A ghost was detected and it took a picture. Do you see anything though? The meter was going off. It said ghost detected. He's here with us.
Oh wait, yeah, he's definitely
he's totally lighting up.
And this is lit. Don't you think? Doesn't that? Oh, maybe not. No, sorry. Got excited. I mean, there is kind of a light there. I don't know.
I'm going to close this and then bring it up in my photos. It saves it in my photos. Rig.
Paper.
Yeah.
Oh. Peter.
So this way we can scroll in on things, because the sometimes it's just a weird thing, like a weird smudge. My kitty.
I mean, okay, I'm my skeptic father is in the back of my mind saying, well, how else? There's got to be other things that could set this off.
Wait, I think it's right here. See that dark?
Mm.
There's dark on there and dark on my leg, like a little streak right here.
Ooh.
Do you see that?
Interesting.
That dark?
Yeah. Yeah, like what else? Could it be a reflection of this?
Let me see. Let me try and take a picture of that. No, because look, when I try to take a regular picture of the same kind of thing, there's nothing there.
Oh.
So he was like right here, and that's when those started going off.
So
he's here with us! He's here with us! Okay, we caught you, Peter.
Oh.
This is getting exciting.
It really is.
I didn't think we'd get such good stuff.
Really?
Here. Yeah, because when you were telling the stories, you were like, yeah, well, my lights flickered. And I'm like, okay, well, your lights flickered, okay. Like, I get what you were saying, like, it doesn't happen all the time.
I mean, you've seen the lights, like, these are not...
These are new, and these are...
Yeah,
it's not like a
lighting. Yeah, yeah.
Some weird old rigging, like, kind of thing. Right, so I can totally see how that would be sort of weird, and especially in correspondence with when it happened.
Yes,
and how,
the way...
And his personality and that kind of stuff. But I still wasn't expecting, like, since that's the most active thing you've seen here, I wasn't expecting to get much. You know, I just thought, oh, it'll be fun. I'll show you my equipment, we'll walk around, you know. But we're actually getting some good stuff here.
I'm excited.
Me too.
I mean, I'm excited and terrified.
Well, no, because we're calling him out and stuff. You're not doing that on a regular basis.
Right.
You know? So we're, like, specifically asking him to come and light up this stuff. So, you know, that's different than just sitting home and not, like, you know.
Okay.
And so what? He's like a guardian angel.
You're
he's monitoring the place.
Yeah.
Making sure everything's good.
It's true.
Well, this was awesome.
Yay, okay.
Yeah, thanks for letting me come over and do this.
Yes, it was
fun. I hope you're not too scared now.
I'm glad it's the middle of the day. Yeah.
Yeah, all ghost hunting doesn't have to be done at night. It does seem that things are more active around 3 a.m.
Oh.
That's like kind of the hour where things really get going a lot of times. But it doesn't have to be. If a place is haunted and there's things there, in my opinion, they're always there.
Yeah.
And so it doesn't. You don't have to wait till 3 in the morning. But
oh my God.
If you aren't getting anything during the day, then sometimes, you know, staying up and seeing if something happens at that hour might really kick things into gear.
Well, this was just, you know, his pied-à-terre. Like, he had other places, obviously. So, you know, But
he spent a lot of time in LA.
And he, like, this is where he lived when he died. Like, his,
when
his
he
widow.
Died here?
Not inside.
Oh, no. I was like, whoa, that's no. a whole, wait, where, which room was that?
No, Cedar Sinai.
Okay.
But, you know, his widow continued to live here after him. So, this, you know, this definitely was, this was the last scene.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure. Well, I'm excited what we got.
Yay.
Thanks for letting me come over.
No, thank you for coming. Thank you, Peter, for being here.
Yeah, thanks, Peter,
for
showing up.
Thanks for having me.
Want to give us one more light up? Say goodbye? Because I'm leaving now.
Aww.
Say one more light up for a goodbye.
If he doesn't light up, it's just because he's angry because he doesn't like to let
say goodbyes.
Beautiful woman.
Maybe he already left, though. One more? One more light up? You have to get close, really close for it to light up. Come on in. Nope. All right. Well, bye, Peter. It was fun talking to you. Maybe I'll be back. I'll come back for your big summer party.
Yeah.